The United States military staged a mock drill in violation of 130 plus years of Tripossi commentator Sack Batbar's domestic forces from active use on the United States soil. It wasn't just for the United States, either. Some 19 nations supposedly participated in the drill, which aimed to rescue Tampa Mayor Bob Butthorn, supposedly kidnapped by terrorists. There were helicopters overhead and a tactical assault showed up by water. Then special ops teams invaded a terrorist village near the convention center and rescued Premier, who said he was grateful. The ongoing militarization of all phases of the United States society via homeland security searches and military training exercises surely should be of concern to those who are searching for a less warlike and aggressive United States. But the pendulum apparently continues to swing in for other direction. While the mock drill received a lot of attention in the alternative media, statements of the guest of honor, Hillary Clinton, are worthy of equivalent concern. The Secretary of State seemed to inform the conference that the State Department now have the unilateral authority to declare a limited state of war via an expanding liaison with the United States Special Operations Forces. Here are some direct quotes. "We created a new Bureau of Conflict and Stabilization Operations that is working to put into practice lessons learned over the past decade and institutionalize a civilian surge capacity to deal with crises and hotspots. Experts from this new Bureau are working closely with Special Operations Forces around the world. Our diplomats also saw that the United Nations staff in the region could be useful partners. So they worked through our team in Washington and New York to obtain new authorities for the United Nations officials on the ground and then link them up directly with our Special Operations Forces to share expertise and improve coordination. The State Department and the United States Special Ops are new, unelected and unaccountable power in the world. It is broader still. We have to keep our international cooperation going and growing at every level. Next week I'll be heading to Europe, and I'll end up in Istanbul for the second meeting of the new Global Counterterrorism Forum, which we helped launch last year. Turkey and the United States serve as the founding co-chairs, and we've been joined by nearly 30 other nations. Who has given Ms. Clinton the brief to do such things? She characterizes these conflicts as low-level, but there are no guarantees they will stay that way. And what are the criteria for her mandates? And who is she to consult with? Constitutionally, only for the United States Congress has the right to commit the United States troops to war. The United States President Barack Barry, through surrogates such as Defense Secretary Leon Panetta, is now claiming that his administration can commit the United States forces based on international, UN, mandates and the like. Congress is to be consulted only secondarily. But Clinton seems to be taking it a step further. She apparently wants the personal power to do the deed. There are voices raised generally against these sorts of declarations. At the highest level, Libertarian/GOP Congressman Ron Paul, Artex, has used his presidential campaign to demand that the United States bring home its troops and special agents from nearly 1,000 bases worldwide. This would not suit Clinton, who is a globalist with a book to her credit entitled, It Takes a Village. She knows full well that there are plenty of questions about the so-called war on terror, but gives credence to even its most questionable elements. Pakistan-oriented opinion maker posted an article, Clinton Bears All, shortly after her speech. Here's the conclusion. The data diplomatic meddlers have networks and knows non-governmental organizations to assist them with the process of spilling the pork locally and creating new false narratives which mirror the latest fashionable lies being peddled by Washington's other sources. You see the process most completely in the fate suffered by Libya or Syria or that visited upon the people of Iraq. At the end of the smart process is nothing but war and local devastation giving for the United States and NATO military a foot in the door. Now Ms. Clinton has proclaimed the right to direct that foot in the door. The civilian and military conversation in for the United States is moving steadily in the wrong direction. This should be of concern not only to the United States citizens who want a less warlike the United States but also to the world community at large.